been great to come up to Mendocino County and meet everyone. I look forward to getting to know this county well. As a Petaluma City Councilman, I make $5 a meeting. And I am out in the community on a day-to-day basis. I work very hard as a council member to represent my city, both at the city level, at the county level, and at the regional level. I'm actually on the board of the Golden Gate Bridge Highway and Transportation District. And there we've been working on labor negotiations, and I'm on the labor committee there. And I represent a very fair view there. Additionally, I'm working on issues around regional planning at Association of Bay Area Governments. These are really critical issues because they address things like affordable housing in our community. Petaluma has been a leader in affordable housing and smart growth principles, and I'm proud to say I've been one of the strongest progressives on my council on these issues. And I look forward to making sure that those types of ideas are going forward throughout this country, because that's what we need in order to break our dependence on foreign oil. We've been focused on transit-oriented design, and this is an idea that is really starting to take shape around the country. So as Mendocino is looking at its issues, I really encourage you to keep these things in mind. I wanted to talk a little bit about labor today. I come from a labor family. My grandfather was a plumber pipe fitter for the Sacramento area school district. He worked most of his life there, and he was exposed to asbestos. And unfortunately, just shortly after retirement, succumbed to lung cancer and died. That union was something that was essential to the future of my family. My grandmother would have been left destitute if it were not for the union stepping forward and ensuring that she had health benefits and survivor benefits after his passing. And that enabled me to help care for her for the next 10 years in her home while she struggled with a life debilitating illness. And we were able to see her pass comfortably in her home. And so I have a huge debt of gratitude for unions. I understand the interconnectedness of what it means to have benefits at the end of your life when you've had a social contract and you've worked hard for your community, for your region. And we're losing that sense of connection around those issues, and it's important that we continue to fight for them, because the more people that don't have retirement benefits at the end of their life end up becoming dependent upon the system, and the system is struggling right now to handle that capacity. We're seeing it on a day-to-day basis, and we need to work to continue to have those types of benefits into the future. So I will be a proud labor supporter as your candidate for Congress and hopefully as your next Congresswoman. I have also been working on issues around the county related to energy. For the last 5 years, I've been pushing community choice aggregation in Sonoma County, building that momentum to bring it forward. And this fall, I'm really excited to, after having reviewed our feasibility study, present that to the Board of County Supervisors, and hopefully they will be moving forward with clean power in Sonoma County. This is something that'll be essential for jobs. It could infuse about $400 million into the county. And so, as you've heard today, community choice aggregation, or clean power, is something that can really infuse both innovative technologies and future jobs into our economies. So as you're working on these issues, I encourage you to meet with me and discuss the challenges and the opportunities that exist out there. It's been a tough road, but I think Sonoma County is one of the places that's going to bring this forward. Additionally, I've been working on Sonoma County Transportation Authority to build jobs in the county, and we've been working on transportation issues to widen our 101. And we've been securing money to bring home to Petaluma for the Petaluma River Bridge and the interchange project. And this was a close one, but I struggled and helped brought almost $100 million home. This is going to create jobs in the next year that are essential for the community. I look forward to meeting with you individually today. I really hope that I get a chance to get your business cards or your contact information. We've got a sign-up sheet. I encourage you to consider joining Team TIFF and checking out my website, TiffanyReneeForCongress.com. I have a long leadership representation around water, air, and other environmental issues, and you can read about those on my website. And I look forward to meeting with you and getting to know the issues around Mendocino County. Thank you very much.